all know that George Washington is America's founding father. But did you know he's also the founding father of mass immunization in America? Now, if Washington had lost the Revolutionary War, there'd be no Washington Monument, no Washington, D.C., and no United States of America. But he very easily could have lost, not so much because of British troops, but because of a virus, smallpox. Smallpox can kill as many as half the people who catch it. It's especially bad in a population with little immunity, like colonial America, where it was comparatively rare. Because the disease spreads mostly through close human contact, gathering people together in, say, a continental army is just asking for trouble. One way to avoid that kind of trouble was inoculation. It's kind of a precursor to our modern-day vaccines. The idea is that you set out to deliberately give somebody smallpox. Yep. Step one, take infectious goop from somebody with a mild case. Step two, squish this goop into a cut in the skin, usually on the arm. And step three, cross your fingers and hope for the best. If you do it right, the survivor gets immunity against smallpox. But there are risks. For instance, when it was tried in Boston during the 1721 outbreak, about 2% of the inoculees died. That's a lot better than the 14% death rate amongst those who caught it naturally, but there was still a lot of opposition. In fact, 18th century anti-vaxxers firebombed the home of the man leading the immunization effort in Boston. They accused him of spreading the disease and defying the will of God, even though he was a minister himself. By the start of the Revolutionary War in 1775, doctors had gotten a lot better at inoculation, but opposition remained. Even George Washington initially thought it was a bad idea to inoculate his men. It would take troops out of the line for weeks at a time. But then, disaster struck. When the Patriot Army was occupying Canada in 1776, logistics were a mess. Men were hungry and starving, and then pow, smallpox. Hundreds died, the survivors fled, Canada was lost. Washington learned his lesson. He wrote to his medical chief that smallpox was something we should have more dread of than the sword of the enemy. He began a comprehensive campaign to inoculate every person in the Continental Army. He had to force some of them, but inoculation helped the Patriots stay the course and win the war. And perhaps that's one reason there's a picture of George Washington on the dollar bill and not, say, Her Majesty the Queen. I'm Chris Wolfe, the history guy for PRI's The World, and if you have any questions about this story or anything else historical, just drop them in the comments below.